We are seeing you and we are hear you. Good morning. Thank you for joining us here. I am here with my co-chair from France. So again, we are happy to see you, Dr. Mathieu, and please show us the description of the case, maybe.
Okay. Jacques, Adam and Jacques, good morning. And I want to introduce my partner, Dr. Ajit Menon, who is standing to the right. And we have an excellent cath lab staff, our chief nurse Christina, our technicians Prasad and Raju. And of course, you can see the full row of... can you move the screen? See our cath lab team, all of them have been very, very well trained, good team we have. Now I'll ask my associate Dr. Anuj to introduce the case briefly and then we'll go on to the case. Anuj?
Hello. Yeah, good morning everyone. We have 55-year-old lady, chronic hypertensive, dyslipidemic, hypothyroid. She presented with rest angina. Was treated as non-ST elevation MI anterior territory in December 2011. Angiogram done in January 2012 showed this eccentric lesion in osteoproximal LAD, which was subsequently stented in the coming February, month of February in 2012. This is the post-plastic picture, LAO caudal view, showing the 2.75 by 23 drug eluting stent. This was in 2012. Again in June 2014, she presented with dyspnea on exertion, class 3 NYHA. Check shoot done in 2014, August 2014, showed these lesions in the distal LMCA, instant restenosis in LAD. The lesion in osteal ramus, currently she is having angina on exertion and dyspnea on exertion, NYHA class 2. ECG shows a normal sinus rhythm, left axis deviation with T wave inversion in anterolateral leads. 2D echo shows no regional wall motion abnormality. She has a non-infarcted left ventricle. Wall thickness preserved with grade 1 mitral regurgitation. Her refusal for CABG surgery has led her here. With that, I hand over the mic to Dr. Mathieu and Dr. Menon.
Okay, now that you have the basic background of the patient, she underwent the angioplasty for the LAD in one of our public hospitals. The angioplasty angiogram did show good result. There was no pinching of the side branches, but ostium of the ramus had some haziness, that's all. Now we'll show you the angiogram today. Yeah, run the play. Next.
So you have the trifurcation lesion, yes?
That's right. We have a trifurcation. And we have yet to decide what whether it is going to be 3 stents, 2 stents.
The first stent,
definitely minimum of 2 stents.
The first stent was implanted from LAD through the bifurcation to left main or only in LAD? How it was?
Only in the LAD.
Only in
the LAD. This is where we are. The previous picture. See that nasty restenosis of the LAD and pinching of the ramus, very tight lesion, very bad angulation. Ostium of the circumflex also is pinched.
Yeah, and we understand that the patient refused resurgery, yes? Redo.
She refused surgery, of course. And even if she does, I feel she qualifies for a lower syndax score. And I feel she should do well with intervention in A. Okay, now what we have done is, before we came live, I have some more information for you. Next picture, we have documented the wiring technique, right was normal. Okay, we are trying to wire into the next. Go back.
Just run it.
Let it run. Run.
So you
trying to get into the LAD, we have to take.
You wired all of this.
We have to. We did not. Now we are wiring the LAD. Next. Next.
By
Next.
The way, your surgeons put,
no, go back.
Put a venous graft to LAD instead of Lima, which is a routine. Do you know why it was that they decided to go for venous graft for LAD, not for left anterior, left internal mammary artery?
She did not go for surgery. Now we have two wires. Next.
Not operated, okay.
That is one in the LAD, one in the circumflex. You see this, the IVUS catheter is already there. And let us, you want to you, show them the IVUS pictures, please. The first one, LAD. This is the IVUS pictures of LAD. You can see a large diagonal coming off. This is a segment which is diseased beyond the standard segment. There is some calcium in that area in the 6 to 9 o'clock position. Now the stent will start showing up. Is little under deployed but not grossly. Proximally there is some more ingrowth. and that is the left main, basically disease free 5 millimeter. We have taken all the measurements. I don't want to delay the whole process showing all the timings. You have seen that. Now I'll show you the circumflex. We did the IVUS run from the circumflex also. A 2.5 to 3 millimeter artery. Slow. Stop there. Now you can see the circ ostium and part of the ramus, LAD stent protruding into this across the circumflex. Across the ramus, which has got a very tight lesion. So that means wiring of the ramus is going to be very, very tricky. You will have to get the wire into the circumflex and pull back and wire into the ramus. That is going to be their technical challenge. This part, because it's going to be difficult, I left it alone so that we can do it together. Can you, are you able to see the wire tip? Show, take, may enlarge it please. No, I don't think you can.
Take short on this.
Focus it better. Very sharp bend. I have kept it all set and let us see whether we will be able to do it.
Give the balloon.
So you have the one wire in
I've taken a C on blue.
Wire in side reflex, and now you would like to enter the intermediate, yes?
Go to LA quarter. That's right. And that we saw from the IVUS we have to avoid the strut, otherwise it will be going to be difficult. Okay, small test. I'm going, taking this wire straight into the circumflex. Okay, now I'll pull back. Small test. Ajitya, hold it. Okay.
Sorry.
Small test. There we go.
Great joke.
Save that. Show that picture again. See, we have got a sharp bend, go into the circumflex. I am pulling back slowly, making the tip look upwards towards the ramus. And allow the tip to fall into the vessel and go in. The purpose of this is to avoid that struts.
Yeah, excellent
epicotomy.
Technique of wiring of intermediate artery.
Now, I've already got a mosaic NC balloon loaded on that. It crossed very easily because we are not in the struts. We are just dilating it. The NC balloon from Merrill, it's a good balloon. I'm sure all of you are very familiar with these devices of Merrill. Okay. Now what do we do? What is the strategy? You want to advise me on that?
Are you planning?
We have three wires.
What are you planning? Are you planning to planning to use drag leaching balloon for the resting of these lesions?
I'm not very comfortable using the drag leaching balloon because I've not seen fantastic reproducible results. Here, what I thought the instant restenosis is partly because the stent selected, we have the information that it was a 2.75 stent. You have seen in the IVUS that the stents are under deployed definitely proximally. That is where the maximum restenosis is. So I would go and redeploy the old stent properly, maybe use a cutting balloon. And you use a three cutting balloon and inflated bell and implant the stent properly and then come back all the way into the left main. Now I have, once I use the cutting balloon, I will use the same cutting balloon to prepare the ostium of the ramus also slightly better. Because an osteo lesion generally.
After cutting balloon, you plan to go with the first stent to intermediate artery or to LAD? What is your strategy?
Probably I will go work on the LAD first. From LAD, we will stent into the left main.
It is an interesting.
There is one thought.
Yeah, we just discussed that if at the first intervention done 3 years ago, maybe stent was not put only to LAD ostium, but through LAD ostium to left main, this may be better for avoiding resting this. What do you think?
That's correct.
It's better or not?
That's correct. I totally agree with you.
It's better, yeah, definitely. But you know, you will put a second layer of metallic stent in the ostium. The risk of secondary restenosis is also much higher.
Now.
Okay.
Well,
This I have to prepare that lesion better. Go up.
So now you have a ramus. Cutting balloon or just regular balloon? Because we can.
Yeah. It's a cutting balloon.
It's cutting balloon.
Negative. Okay. LA cord?
No, dilate the LED.
Eh?
There is now too much evidence
dilate the LED, no?
Using cutting balloon for lesion preparation is better than just the regular balloon, but some people believe that it maybe improved the results, at least the initial result, before stenting.
Yeah, I mean, I believe that it would improve, especially in an osteo lesions. Now what we'll do is we'll go and dilate the LAD. This balloon has lost its profile a little bit, we'll see. Because we used it up in the ramus.
So
if it doesn't cross, then I will.
I'm going
into the LAD.
You are going with the same cutting balloon to LAD, yes?
That's correct, if I can get through. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah, same cutting balloon I'm going up. The Flextome 3x6.
Okay. And how much atmospheres you use? Because there are also divergence.
About 10 atmospheres?
You go ahead.
We've gone up very slowly up to about 10 atmospheres at this point of time.
Negative.
The nominal is 6.
Okay.
Yeah, but there is now a tendency to use more.
To increase the pressure, yeah.
On the other hand, I have to say that
I didn't follow. The tendency is to go higher pressures?
Cutting balloon and rotablation are rather use rotablation. It's more predictable results.
Now here now we are at 14 atmospheres.
The problem was rotablation in bifurcation that you have to not to use a secondary wire. It's a secondary branch. You have to do the rotablation first. So
it's true.
Still
it's
a risk, yeah.
Before you wiring the side branch, yeah, it is the problem.
Typical.
AP cranial. But we regularly do rot ablation of bifurcation because that is one of our very common strategies.
It is tricky.
Yeah. Now I have a, I will go a little more down. Go. Negative. Go up. Now we have one other issue. See, that was the standard segment. We have taken care of that. Take a picture. Now we have a lesion beyond that at the level of the diagonal. Should we start stending across the diagonal or should we stend only from the just the disease segment of the LAD?
You can stop your stend just before the diagonal, you have enough space to do that.
That's correct, we have space.
Yeah, I think there is a room just for stenting only LAD. At the site you did cutting with your cutting balloon. So I understand you would like to attempt this lesion as the first lesion to be stented, yes?
Yeah, what I was thinking is I would do is the LAD, we will stent with a shorter stent, maybe a 24, and then take a 4 millimeter stent for the left main, overlapping onto the LAD stent, is what I was originally planning. I have another issue, whether I should also do a mini crush for the ramus and then implant the stent, because technically I have a challenge which you have seen, that the ostium of the ramus is a bad origin. I could not get sufficient dilatation with a normal balloon. I had to use a cutting balloon. That means I have mechanically produced a controlled dissection there. So this combination may limit my access into the ramus once I stand there ready. What do you think, Ajit?
And the only I mean, that's the only issue is the ramus seems to be originating from the circumflex.
Okay.
So if you crushing the
then the circ access becomes
difficult.
Okay. I hope everybody, I mean, you have followed. Ajit feels that, you know, that ramus actually originates from the left main. It is partially from the circumflex ostium. Can you show that leocaudal? See, go forward. Okay, play. You see this picture.
Hello?
Yes?
I mean,
we can hear you.
After you've treated this ramus, I mean, the images show it comes off from the proximal surface, spondylarum.
Yeah, we think that it is a rather high marginal branch than the real intermediate branch. So it originates from circumflex, not from left main. Do you agree or?
Absolutely, that is giving us the trouble. That is. I will take now, we have dilated the whole lot. I'll take one more leocaudal picture and show you. Come to leocaudal. Then we'll decide. Okay, that's fine. it's all reconfirmed.
Yeah, from that picture is
the stent in the hospital.
But I remember when you did this excellent maneuver with the wire, pulling it back from the circumflex artery, it entered this ramus rather from circumflex than from left leg. It is what we have seen.
Absolutely.
So what is your general strategy now after the predilation and cutting of this lesion? Do you want to use, I don't know, a glass or what?
Yeah, we are waiting for your opinion then.
We are advisory board, but there is an asking
short stance.
Executive, so I personally probably there is a huge difference in diameter between the left main and the LAD and circumflex and this marginal branch, but maybe crush would be nice, or a culo is also not bad from LAD to left main and from the circumflex to left main. Then using maybe only a balloon to redilate the ostium of the intermediate branch. But it is only our proposal for you, so.
Well, your other option is.
To me,
your left main didn't look much. You didn't have much disease on your nivus. You can sort of do a V stent as well.
Okay.
And then follow it up with the balloon into the intermediate as well.
Once we put a V-stent, there will be a tremendous technical challenge, because the stent of the circumflex and LAD will be meeting at the point of the origin of the ramus,
yeah,
or the OM1.
Yeah.
That time to recross with another stent will be a very, very major hassle.
Stenting of LAD, that you will have a second restenosis. The chance for this is high with this.
Absolutely.
In my opinion. So I would rather.
You're correct.
Which assumes that you put your stent from LAD or any other vessel through the left main, through the bifurcation or trifurcation of the left main into left main.
That is
ramus.
Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to fix the mid LAD first, then I'll primary aim is to protect the LAD and get an optimal result, and then I would go for the circumflex, fix both of them, and then finally I will try to reaccess the ramus. If I fail, that's acceptable, but I need the circumflex and LAD fully preserved. And I need the patient to do well.
To protect LAD and circumflex and the ramus, let's say, is not so much important.
Okay.
324.
Samuel, you are working
epicranial.
Seven French guiding catheter or six French?
I'm working with a seven French guiding catheter. I have a left side access also with me.
So you have,
if by any chance I have to use a balloon pump or a three balloon dilatation, I will have an access from the left also.
Okay. So with this seven French guiding catheter, you have possibility to do, if necessary, V stenting. It is with two stents at the same inflated at the same time, if you need it.
Absolutely, we have all that all possibilities are available, and especially with the left groin is also available, we should be able to manage.
Most of the time we are doing left main with the seven French guiding catheter, or we are also using the sheathless from Hazai, you know, the seven French sheathless from Hazai from the radial approach also, which is also very effective.
Okay. I agree with you.
From the point of view, it is a very important point. You just said, Jacques, that seven French for left main bifurcation lesion or distal lesion is much more safer and give you possibility to use different techniques. Six French is maybe for left main shaft or ostial lesion, it's okay, but
we are using every time we are using the seven French or you know the sheathless system.
If you
need large bore. You need large bore, you know.
For me,
to be comfortable,
left
you know.
Stand.
Primary choice.
The complaints chart.
Of course, the
now you have the chroma blood sheets as well, which seven French sheets is an external diameter of six. So I mean, we use radial. Yeah. Most of these using seven French guide with the chroma sheet.
I'm using a Biomime 24x3 and the 11 atmospheres negative.
And what is the deployment pressure? What was the deployment?
11 atmospheres. Now I'll pull back a little and deploy it a little better. 12, 13. It's a very trackable stent, all of you have seen, without any difficulty it went in negative. We went up to 16, and from IVUS we know that vessel size is only small test. Okay, go up. Get me a 4.5. Come to RAO, please. I want to do the measurement of the length. RAO quarter, come. See, because we have a 24 millimeter balloon there, we can roughly estimate what is the length of the stent we need. This is too much of overlap. You have a 18 or 20?
Or
19. Yeah, give me a 19, 4.5.
The LAD stent was a 3 millimeter or 3.5 millimeter?
Three. Because I was showed that the distal LAD was 2.75 to 3. Those are all post-nitro IVUS images.
You probably had gone down further with your cutting balloon than where you deployed your stent.
So no, I didn't. We checked that. I was very conscious of that. You saw the balloons, we were inflating a couple of times and deflating immediately. That was at 1 or 2 atmospheres. Till we positioned it right, we didn't go up on pressure. Anyway, thank you for pointing out that.
Samuel, I understand you would like to cover the LAD ostium and the distal part of left main with that stent, yes?
That's correct.
Okay. Always the discussion is that if you are stenting left main, some people say you should cover the entire left main and some people say maybe it is not necessary. So what is your opinion and what is your attempt at that case?
We generally would like to cover the full left main, because we use very high pressures nowadays to implant, we can injure the area where there is no stent. Okay, go up. We are just at the ostium. Seven, eight, nine. Mind you, part of the stent is into the LAD. I don't want to go too high on the pressure.
Yes.
But you do, you did also a POT technique in the proximal LAD with this.
Go up. Negative. I'm going in a little and 7-8 atmospheres to mold the proximal part of the stent. Negative. Now what I'm going to do is, while taking out the balloon, I have to engage it properly. You have two. I don't want to engage the guiding catheter too deep in, because we have two wires under the stent.
Yeah.
Epicranial. So the first part, it appears that is done well. The LAD left main is okay. Now start, we'll work on the circumflex. Ramus would be the last.
So can we see now the projection which will visualize the spider, please, circumflex? Spider,
oh sure, we'll do that. We'll do that.
Helicoidal.
Table, more, little more layer. Okay. Okay, get me another Sion wire, please.
So you need to rewire the circ first?
Yeah, I'll rewire the circ first.
Good.
And I would probably rewire the ramus.
Sam, are you going to use a false wire? We like to stay with the three wires in place and use another one to rewire. Or are you using the LAD wire?
That's right. No, I will not move the LAD wire till I complete the case. Because that is my primary axis, which I will protect.
Samuel, what do you think about the concept to redilate again the ostial of ramus before you put a stent to circumflex?
Or
you
I will.
There is not
I will.
Necessary.
I will do that. Small test. I'm taking the wire first to LAD. Okay, then pull back.
Now it is important to be inside of the stent in left main and now between the stent and the artery wall.
2 millimeter balloon.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You, you may need a more powerful wire to recross, you know.
Well, the other thing which helps, but obviously you've got two trapped wires, is to do a ports now, and your cell size increases, and it might help you to recross, but you've obviously got two trapped wires.
Yeah. Give me a Fielder FC, please. Sometimes the Fielder wires with the coating helps to rewire.
What is the wire you use, Samuel, now for this recrossing?
I've taken a Sion.
Sion blue.
Keep that wire safely, I will need
what it. You do about these thoughts about trapping wires, because not long back, you're not supposed to trap a polymer jacketed wire, and presuming these are all sand wires, these are all polymer jacketed, so you've got two polymer jacketed wires.
You know, we really don't care. We are using the hydrophilic polymer.
That's right.
For every bifurcation, we don't care.
I guess for left mains, you trap it only for a short distance and you very rarely have any problem. If it's further downstream, that's, I guess, can be a bit more tricky.
So you modified the tip somewhere, or what you did?
Yes, I took another wire.
Another wire. It is again cyan?
It's a Fielder. It's a Fielder wire.
XT.
It's a Fielder wire.
A Fielder FC.
What's Fielder?
Fielder FC.
FC. Okay.
FC. Not so aggressive.
No.
Smaller. AP order, please.
Not working, Mike.
Because the trapped wire, the guiding is pushed down. Okay. Come to LA order. Okay, stay there. Stay there. Okay. Now I'll take a 2 millimeter balloon. Compliant balloon, please. Yeah.
Regular.
12.
12.
We are, I think we only have another 15 minutes left.
You are going to open the cell with a non-compliant balloon or regular balloon?
To open the balloon with a regular balloon, because this gives me a little more advantage by the profile.
Okay, yeah.
I take the other one.
If post initial dilatation, then we may go up with a non-compliant balloon.
Negative.
Table plot. Which is the balloon which you took?
It's a 212
Mosaic. 212. Mosaic. We have taken a 212 Mosaic compliant.
To the wire up.
So the now what I'm going to do is... No.
At what point would you think removing your trapped wire?
I'm removing one trapped wire now, the circumflex. Because once the balloon crossed, I know I'm safe to do that. And go ahead, we'll dilate that.
And you have the second trap wire in intermediate, so I understand.
Yes, we have. See, once I open the struts, I may be able to get the other wire in.
I mean, the way your trap wire came out, it suggests your left main stand is not well deployed yet, so.
Yeah. We had a reasonably good resistance pulling the one trapped wire. It's okay. Okay. Okay.
What balloon did you use for opening the struts? 2.5 millimeter diameter?
Mosaic 2.5.
2.5. Maybe it's not...
Okay. Elia Cordell? Yeah. It's not adequate, but... let us see. If I can get this wire into the ramus, things would be a little more easier. Oh, what I'm going to do is, Walter. AP Cordell. Test. Okay, this is the this is the old wire, right?
This is the old wire, old circumflex wire.
Old circumflex wire. And new circumflex wire.
This one.
Okay, I'll try to get the fielder wire back.
You are going to use a Fielder XT, Fielder FC wire for rewiring the intermediate branch.
I'm trying that because anyway there is two wires there.
Helio Cordell.
Small. There it goes, Epicord.
Excellent.
Thank you. So now I will take the ramus old wire out. Okay. Okay. Now we have the...
now you have a very balloon in the position for further interventions, because all of the arteries are rewired.
Correct.
So the next step will be to open the osteol of the diagonal branch with balloon, or the cutting balloon. Intermediate.
And now I won't use a cutting balloon again.
Yeah, for the intermediate branch.
Yeah. Now what I'm going to do is I'll try if a stent crosses without difficulty. What pressure we went up to?
14.
This is the ramus, right?
This is the ramus.
Give me that 3 NC balloon.
You crush on the ramus?
Yeah, I'll do the 3 NC short balloon. I will open the struts properly.
And what's your plan? How to? What are your thoughts about dealing with this, sir?
Okay, my plan is going to be now. I'll dilate the cercostium well, and get a 3 millimeter stent there. Across the ramus, it's a tap. It's a tap. For the circ, and then I'll have a 4.5 balloon in the, or 5 millimeter balloon in the left main. Deploy those two properly, and finally, I'll get go across the strut into the ramus and do a kissing there.
A little stent from here. So this part is a little.
So now
you
there's some disease there. We'll take a picture. Do we have a short stent, any 8 millimeter?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
3.8.
Go up. We'll use a, because distally it is disease, I don't need a very long stent there. Negative. Yeah. 3 × 8 stent and 5 millimeter balloon.
And on IVUS.
Because
what was the size of your proc circumflex on IVUS?
Main was 5.
You trap the filter.
So now once we do this, we have only one trapped wire, that is the trapped wire in the ramus. That would be the last to come out, and we'll try and fix that too.
We don't want to open again the osteum of the ramus branches branch before putting the stent in the circumflex. We are supposed to do that first, no?
I didn't dilate because I have already used a cutting balloon and prepared the lead.
We missed transfer. Okay. So now you are going where? And with what?
I'm going to the cirque.
With stent?
With the stent.
5 millimeter balloon.
And a 5 millimeter balloon in the LED.
Okay. And it is 3.0 stent?
This is a 3.0 short stent. technically it will be a challenge to position that.
Yes.
But I have some distal disease in the circumflex. I have to manage that.
Samuel, to precisely place a stent in a bifurcation lesion like that, we are currently using the stent boost or equivalent clear stent from Siemens. I'm sure that you have the system in your lab. Are you using it?
Philips, I've got a... Yes, we will be doing it. Okay, LED stand balloon is in position.
So you want to do a TAP, yes? TAP.
Yes. Okay. Take off the cranial, helicoidal. Okay, stand boost here. Make it smaller.
So TAP is a minimal protrusion of the stent in circumflex into the left main and immediate crushing.
Yep. Area corner. Stent boost looks quite good. Okay. Again, a stent boost. Go up.
I'm going. What?
Yep. We are deploying the, because being a short stent, it's a very major challenge.
This one, 8.
Negative. I'll come back a little, deploy it properly. Okay. Negative. Now we leave it there. We will deploy the LED stent correctly. Okay, go up. 7, 8, 9.
This is a 3.5 balloon or
negative.
4 millimeter balloon?
No, this is a 5 millimeter balloon. Okay, go up, Ajit.
Not come back, sir.
No, come back. Go up. 7, 8, 9. Okay, come down to 5. 3.
It is very, very complex.
Negative. Go. We'll take that balloon out or just two atmosphere.
You're out of the stent.
Huh?
You're out of the stent.
Okay. Deploying the other stent, negative. This here I can deploy safely because I have trapped the ramus wire only in the circumflex.
Yeah.
Okay.
This ramus is not bad.
Ramus doesn't look bad, but okay, a picture. Okay. Now what our plans are, I'm going to access the ramus from the left main. I'm not, because now the left main is open well, the circ also open well, the carina has shifted. Carina has shifted towards the left main. So I would be able to get another stent into the ramus, and we should be done with that.
Do you think, Samuel, that the ostium of this ramus was not covered by the stent you implanted a while before the circumcision?
It is covered.
So you need to rewire again the intermediate branch.
That's correct.
Going back to the initial drug-eluting balloon suggestion, and we have had a fair bit of experience in these situations, and often you have a positive remodeling over time. So rather
that
than leaving it only
ballooned,
which
balloon?
This is the
first now leave this drug-eluting balloon rather than a
the
balloon.
Circ.
3-3-9 circ.
Okay.
That is the remus.
Okay, remus. Give me that Sion wire again. Ajit, hold both. I think another 5 minutes, we'll go 5 to 10 minutes. Once I'm able to wire the ramus, then things would be much
Samuel,
more.
What about the heparin treatment? Are you checking the ACT?
We have not checked. We are given sufficient, I think.
6,500.
6,500 units. 100 units of heparin per kilogram body weight. Okay. Usually it lasts, in our experience, lasts quite well, at least for 2 hours.
Give me an ACT anyway.
Anyway, now that you have asked, we will not deny you that figure. We'll give it to you now. Get the ACT, please.
We are only checking for left main, very complex procedure and prolonged procedure, you know, but for every case.
Yeah, we check.
Correct.
The procedure is more than 1 hour. We always check and eventually add more.
Shall I take it?
No, we'll
take it. I check it at 15 minutes.
You take it from there.
So, after the heparin is given. And then if it's therapeutic, then it depends upon the length. I may not check it afterwards anymore if it's a relatively straightforward case. But obviously in long cases of CTOs, you check it every half an hour.
Okay, I put that wire into the LED, coming back, pulling back into the left main. It fell into the circumflex ostium. And here we are trying to get into the ramus.
So you want to repeat the same maneuver you did for rewiring of intermediate high mount?
Again, a Zion wire. Are you using a Zion wire?
Yes. Yeah, it's a Zion wire.
So when you do these cases, which is inactive, and this is for the panel, what dose of heparin do you give? Is there a standard dose? Do you give it for body weight?
Yeah, 100 micrograms per kilogram body weight.
Is that
100 units, sorry.
Do you do it 100 units per
kilogram?
Yeah. Dosing of inelective cases?
Yeah. 100 per kilogram. It is our first dose, standard dose, and then we rather not check ACT routinely, but we check after almost 1 hour after the intervention is prolonged, so we check it.
We the usual dose we are using for regular PCI is the half 15 units per kilogram. We are using half the dose, but we are checking after 30 to 40 minutes CT if necessary.
How it is in France with bivalirudin? You use it or
no?
Not
at all. We start using, but no.
Well, we use it for STEMIs, but after the heat primary PCI, sort of, we've moved away from it a bit.
In Poland, it is dead.
Yeah,
because of these results of the heat PCI in primary PCI, and it is also much more expensive, so we don't use it at all.
I dose it at 80 units per kilogram, especially for electives, but there is work from Newcastle with using 50 for a single vessel electric PCI with no problems at all.
You talk about the unfractionated heparin.
Unfractionated heparin, yeah.
I do have a technical challenge that ostium is really
now,
tight.
Now it is very tricky because you have a second stand, so.
Fielder XT.
Give me a Fielder XT.
Yes, you have to cross the struts of the stand, so it's much more difficult.
Absolutely.
Maybe you can use again a Fielder, more rigid, you know.
Yeah, we are using
smaller.
Thank you for the comment.
Maybe better choice.
Yeah, we are doing that. Hopefully we'll get through.
And Samuel, as for double antiplatelet therapy, she is on aspirin and clopidogrel or what?
We lost the
Brilliant. Ticagrelor.
Ticagrelor. Okay, so you use for elective interventions ticagrelor as well.
Like this, we would prefer because the non-responders in the clopidogrel group is significant.
In your center, Jacques, you reserved this new antiplatelet for ACS only?
Yes, definitely yes.
And in UK?
There is no evidence that new antiplatelets is any better than clopidogrel in elective cases, so, and we can justify the cost. So for elective cases, it's only clopidogrel.
We just switch if we have a secondary stent thrombosis on clopidogrel systematically.
It is very important message to transmit that if you have a
come to epicardial,
so it is maybe better to switch to ticagrelor or prasugrel.
And we prefer prasugrel.
We got the wire in.
Stronger medication.
Yeah.
Yeah. In a way, that shows the difference of quality of the different wires. You know how the way this wire handled the bend compared to the assigned wire.
Go, Leo. Okay. See, the one disadvantage with this wire is the visibility is very poor.
Yeah. Great.
Okay. We are in business.
Yeah.
2 millimeter balloon.
Okay.
1.5 balloon?
1.5 balloon. Okay. Show me the
kissing inflation, circumflex and ramus.
Because I cannot afford to lose this.
Sir, so filter 60. 9. 12.
Okay, I'll get a balloon to support me to get this wire down. I'm taking a 1.5 balloon. Once I do that, I would prepare this lesion to receive a stent. And then I would have the second guiding coming in through the left groin.
Samuel, if after ballooning of this osteal lesion in intermediate artery, you will have an acceptable result with TIMI-3 flow, you will still think about the stent or not?
I will think about the stent, or I will have to use a drug-eluting balloon. I don't know who suggested the. One of you advisors. Who has the experience with the drug-eluting balloon? I don't have much, that's why.
Experience in drug-eluting balloon for bifurcation. We had a publication, a your intervention in January, so with really excellent angiographic results, and we have shown in many patients an over dilatation of the secondary branch after using this secondary balloon. So positive remodeling of the secondary branch also.
Okay, we have got a balloon in.
So you cannot go up. I see with
this
even
one.
This small balloon.
Which is the second
stent struts in.
You remove the second field rex.
One. So I'm removing the fielder wire.
Okay.
Too many wires confuses. Okay, go up. Negative. Epicaudal, I want to get this wire down a little more.
It's in a branch.
It's in a branch.
Side branch there.
But from the perspective of the osteal lesion, it is maybe not so important if you are in the side branch or in the main artery.
This is a fielder XT, that's why it gets into all the small branches. Test. I will leave it there. I don't want to.
Yeah, we agree. It's better to leave it as it is.
Get a 2 millimeter balloon.
Go up again.
We have a 2 millimeter balloon.
Give me a 2.5 millimeter balloon. Compliant.
Wait. No. 2.5.
2.5 millimeter balloon, and and give me the 3 millimeter balloon back. I want to keep it in the circ. I mean, recrossing of the biomim stents are technically not too bad. It's quite good. I mean, we have a real difficult, complex situation to get into the ramus. Still, the balloon crossed without any difficulty.
So now you will take just the regular balloon just to redilate the.
I'm taking a regular 2.5 mosaic and give a long dilatation. But simultaneously, I'll be protecting the circumflex also because I cannot make out.
Are you going to do a kissing balloon
try
inflation?
That.
3 millimeter in the circle.
Yes.
2.5 in the circle. As you know, maybe you know that in France the rate of kissing inflation at the end of bifurcation is decreasing a lot. So we are maybe changing our faces, and we are now more and more using only the pot technique. After we open the struts, we are dilating the secondary bronch.
Table.
We are finishing with a pot technique without any kissing balloon inflation.
I mean, I read a couple of articles from France. It makes absolute sense.
Three.
Neither in.
Yeah, now it's not very convincing result.
This is an NC balloon, no? NC is okay.
Double balloon is better than not, and the pot is just for the optimization of the proximal part of the stand in the main vessel.
Well, from your Nordic studies, it showed that whether you kiss or you don't kiss, in terms of real life outcomes, there's no difference. The only difference is binary restenosis, but that's an angiographic finding rather than a clinical finding. So,
early recorded. More early.
Get a regular balloon. Yeah. 3 9 9
go up a little.
Other thing to remember is every time you kiss, you cause proximal deformations. You have to pot again at the end of it. So potentially you have to pot a part of the circumflex tend, then pot the left main again at the end.
Yeah, I see that now the time of the angioplasty for a very complex lesion is almost like the time for surgery.
Yeah. We ourselves are asking for it.
But at least in Europe we deal with more and more complex coronary artery disease because we treat more and more old patients. I think it's the same in France.
Yeah.
Okay. I remember 15 years ago or 20 years ago, primary angioplasty was done on the patients in the 50s. Now there are 70s, 80s, 90s.
Okay. Our oldest is
go up on that.
So.
Okay, go up on this also. लंबा सांस लेकर ओके छोड़ दीजिए आई जस्ट पुल द बलून बैक अ लिटिल ओके What our plan is, the ramus looks great. We will give a long dilatation for the Ramus and probably use a drug-eluting balloon there, which is all going to take time. Overall, what we wanted to showcase and achieve, we almost achieved. We will end off the procedure with three balloons and port the left main properly, and that would take another 15-20 minutes. I don't want to delay you for that. The teaching part of this case is almost achieved. If you all agree, you can move on to the your next program, or you can continue to stay with us. Anyway, before we sign off, I want to thank Merrill and all your group, Sanjay, of course, the excellent chairpersons, Adam and Jacques, and all the other group there. Thank you for coming to India. Thank you for having me live. And Ajit, of course, we have been working for more than 20 years together, and excellent cath lab staff who works with us.
Okay, congratulations.
Whatever you want, you decide.
Great case. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.